famous for drinking and partying. But can any of us remember what happened after a big night out?
Whoa, yeah.
We're putting groups of mates to the test by inviting them to show us what a banging night out looks like in their town. Yeah! We've travelled across the nation filming these self-confessed party animals doing what they do best.
Drink! We need some drink, guys.
They think they're taking part in a documentary called Britain's Best Night Out. But in reality, we'll edit the highlights from their bender overnight, build a pop-up TV studio around the corner, and surprise them at the crack of dawn to see if they can remember what they got up to the night before. Morning.
Morning.
Morning, Callum.
Morning.
I'm in Malika's.
Did you sleep out here?
No, but I had a pigeon on my shoulder this morning.
Whoa.
All they've got to do is get up, get to the studio, and complete a series of challenges. Physical.
Oh my God, I feel ill.
Mental.
You have to tell me his name.
And undrinkable.
Taste it, go on.
If they succeed, they could win a grand. All while they're absolutely hanging.
Are you ready?
This is the Hangover Games. This week we're in the sleepy Cotswolds, home to six very hungover individuals today. Last night they went on a messy night out in Cheltenham and they have no idea that I'm about to go and wake them up. Morning. Are Dan, Coops and Ed in?
They are.
Are they asleep?
Yes.
Can we come and wake them up by any chance?
Of course.
All right, lads. How you feeling?
Yeah, fine, thank you.
How was your night out last night?
Yeah, very good, thank you.
You were told you were doing a TV show called Britain's Best Night Out. It's not a real TV show. We're making a TV show called The Hangover Games. So if you come with me now, you can win up to £1,000 cash today by coming and playing some games with us. Are you up for that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, we'll go and wake up Dan. All right, Daniel, how you doing?
Very well, yourself.
Nice to see you. My name's Matt. Basically, we've got a pop-up studio down the road. If you come with us, play some games, you get to win up to a grand. You up for that?
Yeah.
We don't know where Chloe is. Oh, have you found her on the map?
She's here.
Oh!
This one here.
This one? Yeah. All right. Is Chloe in?
Chloe's here.
She's not here?
No.
She's not here at all?
No.
I'd knock again, but he's a big bloke. Let's go and wake up the other two and then crack on.
Yeah. Perfect.
Morning, Kareem. How are you doing? If you come and join us, you can win a grand. Clarice, are you there as well?
She's naked.
She's naked, fair enough.
Let's go.
All right, cool. See you in a minute. What's happening with Chloe?
She's on her way.
Alright, guys, so come and join.
All black to all white.
We're just waiting for Chloe, and speak of the devil, here she is.
Oh, God, don't.
Come and join us.
Hello.
Oh. Morning. Hiya. We did actually knock on the door of the house that you ended up at, and the gentleman who answered the door denied all knowledge of your existence.
I asked him about it, and he just went, I ate no grass. And I was like,
okay. Hi, I'm Kareem.
Hi, I'm Chloe.
I'm Ed.
I'm Sam.
I'm Clarice.
And I'm Dan. We love getting battered.
We're from the Cotswolds.
Get battered!
We all met basically in the pub. I mean, a couple of us like know each other from school, but mainly just bumping into each other in the boozer.
Chloe, she's definitely the biggest drinker, I think. She can outdrink me by far when it comes to lager.
Clarice and Kareem are literally couple goals. They are just gorgeous. Like, you see their photos on Instagram, it just makes you want to be them.
I've got nothing on this man here, Keeps. Yeah. He's got okay. He's the real charm. So
he's got a massive cock.
Dan is a little shit. He winds people up, he causes trouble, he's the cheekiest person I think I've ever met in my life, and he does my friggin' edit.
I mean,
look at him.
£2,000 they cost. Ed is the dad dancer of the group. No matter where we are, place, he is in the middle, on that floor, doing what he does best.
The challenge is to get to the Old Town Hall, but it's not as simple as just walking there. You have to get there blindfolded.
Oh, God, here we go.
Well, all bar one of you. And one of you is going to be like a sheep herder, making sure they're all going in the right direction. You've got to do it in under 10 minutes. And whoever the herder is not allowed to touch any of the blindfolded people. You have to guide them with your sweet voice. So who is going to volunteer to be the herder?
Me.
If you want to pass these out, there you go.
Oh, God, this is
horrible. Oh, now I feel even worse. Ow. I don't like me. It.
Don't you?
Oh, my God!
So, your 10 minutes starts now. I'll see you all there.
Okay. Right, are we going forward? Yeah. This is horrible. I already hate this.
Keep going. You're doing amazing. It's just like a little pop there, guys. There's a pop, so be careful.
Oh, you just stubbed your toe?
Oh, God, tell me about it. I'm feeling really dizzy and sick now. I'm not going to lie.
Bush. I'm in bush.
Bush. Dan's getting stroppy with me.
Because you need to walk quicker.
Walk like an Egyptian.
Yeah, definitely the worst thing for a hangover.
I'm not feeling great.
I might go rogue.
Oh, fuck! Oh, that really hurt.
Stop. Back up, guys. Back up.
Everybody chat chat now, y'all.
Take 2 steps to your left, and then walk through the door.
Oh, yeah. 40 seconds left. Hold my just over the back.
Right, guys, blindfolds off. Make yourselves comfortable. You did it in 9 minutes and 56 seconds. 4 seconds to spare. That takes your total to £200 straight away. Welcome to the Hangover Games studio, guys. I hope you like it. It's built in the town hall. Like all game shows that have glamorous and gorgeous assistants, this one's no different because I have Ken Cheng.
That is the first time anyone's called me gorgeous who's not a fake Tinder account trying to get my credit card details.
Now, Ken is somewhat of a maths genius, and he is here to keep score and keep track of your progress. Now, guys, how hungover are you right now?
I'm going to die. I don't know, I'm still here. I'm a hollow shell of a man.
What's the weirdest thing that's ever happened to any of you on a hangover?
Go on a game show.
Very nice. How much do you remember about last night?
Bits and
flashbacks.
Well, let's look at your highlights of last night. Chloe and Sam, how much of that snog do you remember?
I don't actually remember any of it.
Not a lot of it. Has that happened before?
Oh,
no. Are you sure? How would your special friend we found you with this morning feel about it?
I think he'd be okay, but, you know, you might not be.
So, I'm sure your heads were absolutely banging this morning, so it's time to play our second game, Banging Headache. Guys, if you thought your head was banging beforehand, it's about to get a whole lot worse. I'm going to test your memory from last night. I'm going to ask you a series of questions. If you think you're the answer to the question, all you have to do is bang your cymbals against your heads. Do you want to give them a quick test now just to see what they feel like? Not great on a hangover, right? Sam,
that's
you look quite in pain at the thought of that. So, first question. One of you interrupted another while they were relieving themselves last night. Who was involved? All right, let's see if you're right.
I don't even remember that.
I'm afraid I can't give you the point because you were involved, Kareem, but you didn't bang your head. So I'm afraid no point for that one. Which two of you were involved in a three-way snog last night? OK, let's see if you're correct.
Dirty bitch. Did I miss that bit?
Yeah, you're correct. Well done. Next question. Who described their food last night as gritty? Oh, let's see if that was worth it.
Hands and knees. Hands and knees it.
Oh, gritty.
That was correct. Well done. Why did you pick it back up?
Oh, mate, it's still warm, so...
That is not an excuse. Ken, how do they do?
Well, they got the majority right, which means they're now on £400.
Right, that's it for part one. But like any good night out, things get really out of hand in the second half, so we'll see you in a bit. Welcome back to the Hangover Games, the show that turns the worst part of a hangover into the best. Are you feeling all right, guys?
Yeah,
to recovery.
I've heard a few of you have had worse hangovers than this. Like, Sam, did you once throw up all over yourself on a night out, sat in the street and someone thought you were homeless and you ended up with 100 quid in your lap?
Is that true?
Yeah, Banbury.
What did you use 100 quid for?
Oh, I don't know. Well, I threw up in the taxi on the way back, so most of it went on paying for that.
So, hopefully, another chance to win a load of cash is going to perk you lot up even more. So we're going to play our very own version of Spin the Bottle. Which one of you would like to be the bottle?
I'll be a bottle.
Well, OK, Sam's going to be our bottle, so let's play Spin the Bottle. So if you want to have a lie down for me, just get comfortable, spin you around. You happy? Okay, yeah, right. Now, you guys might think that Sam has got the short end of the stick. However, you have to face this. This is everything that you ate last night. It is a blended kebab. The way this game works is you've got 90 seconds between you to drink a yard of blended kebab. And simply, who has to drink it is determined by whoever's name the bottle lands on.
That's grim.
You drink for as long as you possibly can. As soon as you stop, you spin the bottle and the next person drinks. If you finish the yard, you win the money. Bottle, are you ready?
Yes.
Let's do this. Chloe, you're first. That starts the clock. As soon as you start drinking, the 90 seconds starts. Come on, Chloe, we really want you to win the money. As much as you can, even if you can only do a little bit.
Oh, can I put it back?
Can spin the bottle then. Spin the bottle.
Oh, it's spicy.
Dan, come on, Dan. Come on, boy. Come on, man. Spin the bottle, quick! Kareem! Yes! Come on! 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1! He didn't even taste it!
That is fucking vile.
Well done, massive round of applause. See? Edward, you got off scot-free.
That's class, isn't it?
You've not won the money so far, OK? However, I am willing to give you the £200 if Ed necks the rest of it by himself. Ed, give it a go, son.
Someone get him a bucket.
Don't smell it.
Just go for it. Don't think about it.
Oh, go on, Ed.
Go on, Ed. Go on, Ed. Go on, mate. Come on, we want you to win this. We want you to win this. Good luck. That was so impressive. Take a seat, mate. We'll get you a towel in a second.
I got off all right, didn't I?
You got off fine.
Can't complain.
Ken, how do they do? I mean, Ken, what are you doing?
Oh, I had no interest in taking part of this ritual, so I decided to label my floppy disks.
I've got so many questions. Number one, who has floppy disks anymore?
Oh, Matt, sorry for being romantic about the past. Some people read by candlelight. I use floppy disks. It makes me feel young again.
Ken, they've completed the challenge. What's their total now?
Well, that means they're now up to £600.
Yay! We're going to go straight on to our next game, which is What Happened Next? I know you six were very heavily intoxicated last night, so what I'm going to do is test your memory of the night out that you had. I'm going to show you a series of clips, and all you have to do is tell me what happened next. If you get the answer right, well done. If you get it wrong, however, you will all receive an electric shock, as we have wired you up to some electric shock pads. Actually, can we quickly just test those out? Is that all right? Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, let's see the first clip.
Let's rock this shit.
Oh my god, Ed!
Right, what happened next?
I think Dan pulls my trousers down.
I do indeed.
Dan pulls your
right
trousers
by
down.
And boxes by his ankles.
Are you pretty sure about
100%.
That? 100%. Let's have a look.
It was Carl.
Oh my god, Dan!
Well done, you got it right. Okay, let's see the next clip.
Your chicken, please. Ooh. Please.
Honestly, the chili mayonnaise smells weird.
What happens next?
Right. I smack a whole kebab into this gentleman's face.
Yeah.
Let's see if you're right.
Smell it. I'm dare you.
Honestly.
Yeah,
congratulations!
All right, mate, don't worry.
I can't believe you fell for that.
Absolutely battered, mate. So.
Fair enough. Guys, you're doing so amazingly in this round. It's actually annoying me a little bit. You're absolutely on fire. You could say the atmosphere in here is electric.
Oh, you turned it back.
Still going.
Okay, so I'm going to show you another clip. Let's have a look. What happens next?
Do you know, Coops?
Just neck on.
You neck on. Right, let's have a look at the clip, shall we? That isn't the question, if you got that right or wrong. To make sure your friends don't get an electric shock, what was that girl's name?
Hannah.
Hannah is annoyingly correct, for God's sake! You got through that one pretty scot-free, guys. Ken, how do they do?
Well, they got all of them right, which means they're now on £800.
Congratulations! So, guys, this is the last chance to win some more money, and one of you is going to have to endure hangover hell and take one for the team. It involves one of these. So, which one of you...
You ain't got a fucking chance to get me with that.
Okay, that's you. You look the bold.
Got it. Go on, then.
Edward, well done. And let's get ready to play Hangover Hell. Now, I don't know about you lot, but there's nothing that makes me feel more self-conscious than how I look when I'm hungover. And the thought of someone coming along and making me look worse is my own hangover hell. But that, my friend, is what is going to be happening to you. Does anyone want to come and help me out? Yes. We're going to go for the lovely girl here. Hello, come over, give her a massive round of applause. What's your name?
It's Gemma.
Gemma, nice to meet you, Gemma. Now, I am going to get you to make him look as awful as humanly possible. And whilst this is happening, his five friends are going to have to answer questions about the things they got up to last night. It's 10 questions, each one's worth 20 quid. All five of you have to get the question correct to win the money. As long as Edward endures the hangover hell, you can keep answering questions. As soon as he says no more, the game stops and you can't win any more money. We're going to start off nice and easy and go a bit retro with a couple of lines in your eyebrow. Right, so, who got pied by an older lady in the bar last night? Oh, very G. Let's have a look. That is Sam, correct. Yes, well done, you got that right. Who pulled Sam's trousers down inside the kebab shop? Good. The answer is Kareem, that is correct. Yes, well done. Let's have a little look. That is quite extreme, isn't it?
Ed, it's fine, it looks really good.
Who licked beer off the floor in the first bar? I'm afraid it was Kareem, so you've let down the side, Clarice. No money for that one. Which two of you did strawpedos with some randoms last night? Well, I'll give you that. It was Dan and Sam, yes, well done. Question number five. Who accidentally put their thumb up Clarice's nose? You look like you're in The Prodigy. The answer, I'm afraid, was Chloe. You didn't get that one. OK, which of you two swapped shoes to walk home?
Absolutely hairless.
The answer was Sam and Chloe. So you all got it right, apart from you, Chloe. He went with Kareem, so no money on that one. Question seven, who saved their kebab so they could have it for breakfast? Oh, my days.
Jeremy, you're doing a real nice job.
Oh, no.
You are correct, it was Dan, yes. OK, and we're going to move on to the eyebrows. So, who literally had a chip on their shoulder last night? When you're ready?
Take your time, Gemma.
Sam is correct, yes, well done. Which two of you fell over dancing in the club last night?
That says Clarence.
Chloe and Clarice. Right, quick, and the other eyebrow, do it for the final question. Which three of you went to bed singing with the best three friends in the whole wide world? Ed, Sam and Dan is absolutely correct. And have you all got it? Yes, you have. Well done. Congratulations. So, let's have a look. Oh my God.
He's an absolute hero. Oh,
everyone give Edward a massive round of applause. Look at that.
Oh, Ed.
Ken, how do they do?
They got seven questions right, bringing their grand total up to £940.
There you go, my friends. Pass it around. Guys, congratulations, well done on winning so much money. Edward, well done on taking that. That was incredible. What are you going to spend the money on?
New haircut, I reckon.
A new haircut. Thank you so much. Give a massive round of applause to our wonderful team. That's it for this Hangover Games. But remember, the next time you're in bed cradling a bucket, trying to remember what you did the night before, and you hear a knock at the door, it could just be me asking you to play the Hangover Games. Good night.
We're getting absolutely on it again. 100%. Ready to splash that cash we made today and hope to have some in the morning left.
No eyebrows, that is a new one, if I'm being completely honest with you.
I think it does suit you, though.
Cheers, mate. I look like a foot, I look like a toe.